Today we're testing the 11-inch iPad Air M3. Key upgrades include the M3 chip and increased base storage from 64GB to 128GB, up to 1TB. It comes with a dual USB-C 3A cable and a 20W USB-C charger. The length of the cable is about 1 meter and adopts a woven design. Charger Lab Power's EKM003C shows it doesn't have an eMarker chip. The model of the charger is A2940. It supports a maximum output of 9 volts 2.22 amps. The iPad Air, compared to the previous model, has minimal design changes aside from the new color. The iPad text and model serial numbers on the back have been removed. The top features a fingerprint sensor button and speaker grille, while the bottom has a USB-C port and speaker grille. The USB-C port supports a 10 gigabit per second data rate, DisplayPort video output, and accessories like keyboards, mice, and headphones. The side features a magnetic connection for the stylus and the volume buttons. The screen is a Liquid Retina display with a resolution of 2360 by 1640, a peak brightness of 600 nits, and supports P3 wide color gamut and True Tone. The back features a 12-megapixel single camera, with three contacts at the bottom for connecting a keyboard. Next, let's do the charging compatibility test. Apple's charger power ranges between 18 watts and 29 watts, with a maximum of around 30 watts, supporting 9 volts and 15 volts voltage levels. The third-party charger has a maximum charging power of 31.32 watts, which is similar to Apple's charger. It supports 5 volts, 9 volts, and 15 volts PD2.0 charging with a current of around 2 amps, and there are no compatibility issues. Next, we'll use the Apple 70 watts charger to fully charge the iPad Air M3 and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. The voltage is always around 15 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 6 parts. In the first part, the power stayed at 27 watts for the first 16 minutes. Next, the power drops to 24 watts. Then, the power rises to 26 watts. After 52 minutes, the power gradually drops to 18 watts and 15 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 41 minutes. The power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 16 minutes to be fully charged. The Apple 70 watts charger can charge the iPad Air M3 to 50% in 45 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 1 hour and 22 minutes, 100% in 2 hours and 16 minutes. The charging speed is slightly slower than expected. We also recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 20 minutes, 40 minutes, and 60 minutes. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.3 degrees Celsius. The back is 37.8 degrees Celsius. After 40 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 37 degrees Celsius. The back is 42.4 degrees Celsius. After 60 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.8 degrees Celsius. The back is 42.7 degrees Celsius. During charging for 1 hour, the temperature is between 36.3 and 42.7 degrees Celsius. The charging power is maintained between 18 and 27 watts within 60 minutes, and the temperature is relatively high. In terms of charging compatibility, speed, and heat generation, this generation of iPad Air shows little change compared to previous models. The maximum power is around 31 watts. It has good compatibility and works well with most chargers. However, the charging speed is not very fast. It takes about 45 minutes to charge to 50% and over 2 hours to fully charge, which is considered normal but on the slower side for Apple devices. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.